This is in the base of the tower on the Small's Lighthouse. That's the door you would normally come in on a boat relief. And it was always a step off the boat, not a winch job on this lighthouse. As you can see, this is quite a tiny tower inside, so space is quite rare. You have to put things where you can find a gap. Okay, up to the next level. The next level is the winch room level, and this is where they used to store the water as well. This is the, just passing the winch, bit of a workbench. Winch goes up and overhead and would slide out to the door that's behind you now. And the winch obviously for bringing stores on board, enough and heavy that you couldn't manhandle up through the door. Although you still had to manhandle it once you got it in the doorway. Come into the doorway now, held shut by those sort of bolt things. Right, you can see that there's no stairs in the first couple of levels. I think they took them out just to be able to get more room. You go up that ladder and you're straight into the next room, which is the engine room. In here you have two engines, A and B, and there's one running 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and it alternates with the other engine just to give it a rest. And the reason for the engines is everything is powered on a lighthouse out to sea by an engine. Up the next ladder, and the next room is one. You have to bear in mind this is after they took the men off here and it's been automated, so what they've done in this room is weird. There's a shower, a toilet, a fridge, the engine controls and a hot water tank. So I don't think it would get passed by the planning department if this was ashore, but this is in a cramped lighthouse, so you put it where you can get it. These are the controls for the engines. Right up to the next level, and you know, back to being on proper stairs again. And you're going up to the kitchen level. And the kitchen is a kitchen stroke living room. And this is where the free keepers that were out on these places spent most of their free time. This is looking a bit clinical in my eyes, because when they take men off of these places and automate, they rip all the old stuff out and just put brand new in. So and of course when men were here, you didn't have all those metal truncheons going up the wall with loads and loads of wires, but that's all for the automation. You can see you don't get a lot of room in these towers. That's the bit of a vegetable store in the window. Up to the next level, which is the bedroom. And in the bedroom, this the only form of privacy you get is a curtain. So there's three men in there, and if you're unlucky to have a maintenance crew come out as well, you could have two more in there as well. So not an awful lot of room. Next level is up to the sector light and battery room. And the sector light is a fixed red light shining constantly over the hats and barrels rocks, which is out of this window. Coming up any second, hopefully. That one there. And there's the sector light. You can see finding storage places is a premium in a lighthouse. Red boxes there were for our food and whatever, and that fitted nicely in the back of the helicopter. And that was our radio, a link with the outside world. Now up the final flight, and that takes you up to the lens. And this was before they put flush toilets in these lighthouses, where they would have the old Elson bucket under the lens. So it was a case of bucket and chuck it, as we used to call it. Toilet facilities I'm talking about. Now this lens above, what governs the flash on a lighthouse is the circles in the middle of the lens. It's like beams of a car headlight going round, so it appears to flash to the ships or to you if you're on a clifftop somewhere and can see it. And all the prisms around the lens sort of gather the light towards a beam, but the main magnification is the circles in the middle there. What we call bullseyes. And that little elephant's ear flapping round going past, that was, these lenses were made before they had electric light bulbs. So they were made for a less powerful light source. So now you've got big electric bulbs. Some lighthouses give a funny little flash off the prisms, so those ears they stuck on the side is to try and stop as much as that odd flashing as they could. And this is out onto the gallery, the only other area where you can get out and walk around, or walk as far as you can. And if you notice, the glass panes in the lens room are square, where lots of lighthouses are normally triangular. The ladders we keep passing are to go up to the helipad above. The only other form of exercise is walking round and round on the helipad. Or on a very, very fine day, you can perhaps get out and walk on the rocks just at the base of the tower. Now, on the training, when I was a lighthouse keeper, in line with lots of other keepers, we were told the story of why there was always three lighthouse keepers on our lighthouse. And we were told that in the days of 2 months on, 1 month off on a lighthouse, in the 1800s, they had two men, and it stems from a tale about the Small's Lighthouse, the original wooden one. And two men went out, and they were, one of them was an argumentative soul, and they were seen to be arguing. Anyway, they go out, and storms brewed up, and one of the keepers died, supposedly of natural causes, and the other one, who was the argumentative one, didn't want to be accused of killing him, so he kept his body for as long as he could out on the gallery. And storms brew up, and it took forever for them to be taken off, and in the end, from the shore, they noticed that the light had long gone out. This was in the days of candles and oil lamps. So eventually, when the storms eased and they got out, they found one dead keeper and one who had gone mad. And we were told this story, and that's the reason we were told why we now have three lighthouse keepers.